Hey everyone, welcome to the third episode in our introduction to differential equations, where today we'll be looking at slope fields and intervals of validity. Slope fields are a way to visualize differential equations of the form y prime equals f of xy. Recall that the derivative of a function y represents the slope of a tangent line to the function. Here we're saying that at some point, xy, the slope of the tangent line is equal to f of xy. The best way to learn is with an example. Y prime equals x times y minus 1 squared. Remember, we're solving for a function y of x, which we should be able to graph in the xy plane. If we isolate a single point, say 3, 2, without explicitly solving for y, could we find the gradient of our function at this point? The answer is yes, and that's by plugging 3, 2 into f of xy. This should hopefully make sense because f of xy is equal to y prime, which is the gradient of the tangent line. Here we can see that the slope at 3, 2 would have to be 3. So what we're going to do is draw a miniature tangent line at 3, 2 with a slope of 3. We can repeat this process for the rest of the points on our grid. What we've ended up with is a rough guideline for how our function would look. I want you to note that there is a slight caveat to this. Here we've graphed the slope at every point, but our final function y can't go through every point. What we've traced here is the slope field for the family of curves that could pass as our function. If we're given an initial condition, we can use the slope field to graph what we call an integral curve through the slope field. For the sake of practice, I recommend you get a piece of grid paper and try graphing the slope field for y prime equals y squared minus 1 times x minus 1. And while you're at it, draw the integral curve through 1, negative 2. You should get something that looks like this for the slope field and something that looks like this for the integral curve. Now we're going to go over intervals of validity. Sometimes when we're solving a differential equation, our specific solution may have some breaks in continuity. When we're looking at real-world applications, solving a differential equation means that we'll also need to show where our solution applies. First, we need to find all of our vertical asymptotes, points of discontinuity, and domain restrictions. Next, we need to see between which of these breaks our initial condition lies. We'll do plenty of examples with intervals of validity in the future, but I'll just do one here so that you get the gist of it. Let's say we've solved an IVP with initial condition y of 2 equals 0. Our final specific solution is y of t equals natural log of t minus 1 over t minus 3. There are two things we need to pay attention to, the natural log in the denominator of our fraction. Notice that with natural log of t minus 1, whatever is inside the log always needs to be positive. So we have the general restriction that t minus 1 is greater than 0, which means t is greater than 1. Also, remember that the denominator of a fraction can't be 0. If we add 3 on both sides, we see that we have an asymptote at t equals 3. We have two breaks in our function, and our initial condition existed at t equals 2. So, we know that our interval of validity is between 1 and 3. 1 is less than t is less than 3. Just for fun, here's what our function looks like, and here's what it looks like with the domain restrictions applied. In this episode, we've learned how to draw slope fields, sketch integral curves, and how to find intervals of validity. If you have any questions or spotted any mistakes, feel free to leave a comment. In the next episode, we'll start solving separable differential equations.